I haven't told James yet, so I'm about to break the good news to him. I don't know if it's going to be good news or not, because he may have a heart attack.
No.
Straight up. Like, when do you want him?
Dude, I just got goosebumps. Miracle. Never happened.
Right.
Ever.
Day 76. There's nobody here. It was like mad stations on Saturday. Plumbers were here. The lumber guys were here framing. Crazy, crazy. The electricians are supposed to be here today. And my roofing guys still haven't finished the roof. What is going on? The main roof was finished weeks ago. They've been piddling with this little back section over here. And yeah, I am going to shout them out because, like, get the job done. If you're going to start something, finish it. I teach my kids that. Let me show you something really cool. This is a big pipe going all the way up, all the way across. You can see it through the, there you go. You see it through the beam. That is the waste pipe for the toilet upstairs. So I've decided to call these poopy pipes. I need a marker so I can write on it. I'm going to trademark that name. I'm going to start my own range. Uncle Mikey's Poopy Pipes. You heard it here first, folks. And this, just so you know, is a metal plate to make sure that nobody screws a nail trying to hang a picture into said poopy pipe, because that wouldn't be good. Hi, kitty cat. Starting off day 77 with the cat who has been named Donald Trump. Don't ask why. It's my son's cat, and that's what he decided to name it. So, Donald, are we going to go for a walk? Day 77. Today is tree day. I've got a lot of trees with limbs and whatevers that are too low, hanging out and all that kind of stuff. So I decided to get the chainsaw out and start chopping. The problem is I didn't have anyone to film, and I needed two hands to saw.
Wow.
Just trying to lift that level up a little bit, dude. There's a whole lot of branches down here. And this one over here. Again, I got as high as I could go, but Mikey can only reach so far. And then this was the big one. Proper thinned out. Still getting a little bit near to the corner of my walls there. So I'm gonna have to figure that out. But holy moly, I got branches everywhere. Did I say I'm gonna have to go rent me a wood chipper now to get rid of all this? Bit of a fail on this one. They're all growing down, but I can't reach high enough. And then I took a few off that one as well. It is a glorious day 78. I'm having a very productive week considering we haven't had a lot of work going on. Plumbers still haven't shown up. I think they're waiting on some valve parts. So we thought we'd do some yard work. I've been chopping down trees, which you've probably already seen. Mowed the yard some more, making it look a little bit prettier. And then the roof guy showed up out of nowhere today with a whole crew. We're gonna go check out what's going on, but I'm feeling pretty good because it looks like I'm gonna get my roof finished off maybe today. And then I had some good news with the business yesterday in Houston, so that was kind of fun. Dude, I'm just having a good week, you know? I hope you are too. Literally, Linda just cleaned this entire patio up this morning, and within minutes of finishing and having it all spick and span and spotless, the roofing guys showed up. And they've made a mess, oh my word.
So I decided, you know, that y'all weren't seeing enough of me doing work. So I set up a GoPro and I thought I'd clean up the patio. Yes, within like, what, an hour of it being clean, the roofing guys showed up, which is good news, the roofing guys showed up, but yes, they made a mess.
Yeah, so can you go clean the house now so someone shows up to finish working in the house, please, because there's no one there.
Yes, I did have a little bottle picking up session this morning.
Thank you.
Bottles, cans.
This is the good side, and then this is the bad side. All those brand new shingles just got wasted and came off. Here we are over here on the smoky side. And thankfully, there's a dumpster right there. I'd like to say that was great planning, but I don't think it really was. I think it was more dumb luck. Oh, there's my kitchen. Yeah, should have put a fireman's pole in here.
So when we were reviewing some of the footage that we got this week, I saw one dodgy bit of footage that I hadn't seen in real life, and that was you standing on the rafters with a big gaping drop beneath you. Would you like to explain?
That's why I was on the rafters, so that I wasn't in the drop.
I know, but it scares me. Like, you got to be careful.
Well, they hold the roof up. I only weigh 190 pounds.
Saying, you're not really a spring chicken now or an athlete or anything, so just be careful is all I'm saying.
Day 79. I'm running a little bit of cleanup mode here, trying to get ready for the weekend. We've got a special guest coming to see us. Can't tell you more about that right now. And today, I started tackling the stairs. All that's got to come off, all the way up. So figured why not? As good a time as any. It's absolutely glorious outside, and I'm sweating buckets. Okay, so we're taking the stairs off. Holy moly. Came to the top one. Smells like barbecue under there. Big time. Well, Mr. FedEx just dropped off a package. This is a very special package, and I'm gonna explain why in just a few minutes. Well, actually more than a few minutes, because I'm hot and sweaty and I'm still demolishing stairs, but I've been waiting for this bad boy, I think maybe since before Christmas. And it's actually connected to something that I ordered way before then, and I'm not gonna get for another year or two. So that's got you thinking, hasn't it? Okay, so I had a package delivered that was a very special package. I've been waiting for like 7-8 months for this thing to arrive. And here it is. But a little while ago, there was a company that made a rather fancy looking car. It was in a small movie that most people have never heard of. And there was a time machine built into the car. Michael J. Fox was the leading actor. And the movie was Back to the Future in 1985. And the car was a DeLorean. Well, Mr. DeLorean is making a new DeLorean. Not going to be shiny steel. It's pretty colours. And so I pre-ordered one. I don't have a lot of vices in life, but I thought I would treat myself to something that hopefully will go up more than the stock market. And so I have a DeLorean on order. And then they released a DeLorean watch. Manufactured using original stainless steel and parts from the 1980s DeLoreans. And so here is my limited edition DeLorean watch. I haven't taken it out. I don't intend on taking it out. I will never wear it. It's just a collectible, okay? So I'm leaving the plastic on it as well. But this is literally stainless steel from an original DeLorean, recycled, repurposed. And I think it's pretty cool. So this is my retirement right here, okay? Because I'm broke, thanks to the house. I got the easy job here. This is AC unit number one. Don't drop it, dude. Here, I'm gonna come and help you. Our driveway's steeper than it looks.
It's in your shirt, Troy.
Redneck trampoline, baby. Yeehaw! I should have brought my cowboy hat. It would go really well with these shorts.
The mom and the dad of this fucking horse are both playing the NFR. Kenny, Billy, Billy, Shitty. Yes, he will. Here we go. The start. Set free. Set free. Here we go.
It never stops. Even coming home from the rodeo, 10:30 at night, still chucking some stuff in the dumpster, trying to stay on top of things and not kill my grass.
Yes, but you did a great job because that was super heavy, that pallet.
It was heavy.
So you did good.
It was big, like really long. It is day 80, 80. Can't believe it's been 80 days. Kind of doesn't feel like we're making a whole lot of progress sometimes. But anyway, about 3 weeks ago, maybe 3.5 weeks ago, we paid for our windows that originally we were worried we were going to take 12 to 18 weeks, but they said it would take about 6 weeks. In actual fact, they are ready, except I haven't told James yet. So I'm about to break the good news to him. And I don't know if it's going to be good news or not, because he may have a heart attack, realizing we've got to now install these windows and we might not be ready for them. So I guess we're going to find out in just a few minutes.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
That's
yeah. Dude, did you see my handiwork? I'm quite impressed.
Oh, I want to hear the good news.
Well,
what's the good news? What'd you do? Oh. Whoa, yeah. You did that?
Dude, I couldn't even find my hammer. Nobody wants to own up to having moved it. I had this really nice, like, mega framing hammer in Milwaukee that I just bought that's gone AWOL. So it was just a crowbar, but I couldn't get it. There's like three steps and I just could not get it to get me a gap. But yeah, it took me a little while.
That was the project of all projects you tackled. That's a good one.
I mean, I thought so. I did awesome on the stairs. Can I just say, my hammer seriously never showed up. Like my brand new $30 Milwaukee hammer has gone. So I had a crowbar and you know, they glue the wood of the stair treads and things on. So there's not really a big gap to get the crowbar in. With a hammer, I could have hit said crowbar and made myself a gap, but I couldn't find that hammer and I didn't have another lump hammer handy because it was somewhere in the barn unpacked or packed, not unpacked. So I had to do the whole thing with just a crowbar, hitting it with my hands of steel.
Approximately how many times did you hit yourself in the face with the crowbar?
I don't actually think I hit myself in the face with the crowbar.
Oh, you did the...
Yeah, you did. Yeah, maybe once or twice.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah.
And that's probably the second time in your life that you've done that.
Okay, but it bounces out. Like, sometimes it just does that. If you've used a crowbar, you know what I'm talking about right now. So we're going to form our little crowbar anonymous group and we can hang out. And all those uneducated people out there, go get a crowbar and, like, yank on it a few times and see how long it takes before it, like, flicks back in your head.
I don't think that's what they're going to do.
I'm just saying it happens.
But no, that's not what it is. No, so, dude... My man Ben from Pella calls.
Uh-oh, Ben.
Dude, windows are here.
No.
Straight up.
No.
It's like, when do you want them?
Dude, I just got goosebumps.
So there's only been 3 weeks, Ben. You said
he's
six.
Such, he cracks me. I'm going to use
right?
Him. He's so stoked about this house.
Well, I just texted him and I was like, Ben, just trying to get an update. You know, do you think we're going to be good for like, you know, early June? And then he literally calls me. He's like, Mike, the windows are in. Like, when do you want them? I said, well, not sure we can take him today, but I'll talk to James tomorrow.
That's huge. Oh my God.
Right?
I'm like super pumped. That's
I know.
A miracle for custom windows. Miracle. Never happens.
Right.
Ever. I'm just going to start saying I'm on YouTube.
Right.
That's all I'm going to start doing. I just go on my job and I'm like, listen, I'm a contractor, but I also have a YouTube channel.
Right.
I just, one subscriber. It's my wife.
Yeah.
And I, you know, we think this might go viral, so we got to just, I need a disco.
I haven't met you yet. Come on. Oh.
We say Donnie and the dog shows up.
This is Harley, by the way. She's feeling left out because she doesn't get any attention.
No, we don't need the dog.
Harley's been with us for 10 years.
Troy, we're going to have to do this in reverse. So he's driving up the driveway. Yeah, we're going to have to use. Sir, we're going to have to use.